get clear and solve the problem. Then I will take examples based on, now I will take the example based on not covered under the Gratuity Act 1972, not covered under the gratuity payment of Gratuity Act 1972. Okay, whatever problem already explained related with Gratuity Act, covered under Gratuity Act 1972. Now I will take the example based on not covered under payment of Gratuity Act. You see here. Mrs. Sneha received 3 lakh rupee gratuity on her retirement on 30th September 2019. She was working in a private company. At the time of retirement, she was getting per month 10,000 basic and DA rupees 5,000. Okay, DA 5,000, salary 10,000. And DA is eligible for retirement benefit only 75%. This is the point you have to remember. What is the difference between covered under Gratuity Act, not covered under the Gratuity Act? Covered under the Gratuity Act, DA is fully taken. DA is fully taken. But not covered under the Gratuity Act, eligible amount is to be taken. Out of 5,000, eligible for retirement benefit is to be taken. Okay, 10,000 plus 5,000 is to be taken if he covered under Gratuity Act 1972. If not covered under the Gratuity Act 1972, you take 10,000 plus eligible amount of DA, not 5,000. 75%. 75% of this 5,000 is, I think, 3,750. Okay, totally 13,750 is the salary you have to take. And he served for 25 years, 8 months. 25 years, 8 months he served, but you have to take only 25 years because not covered under Gratuity Act. This is the second point you have to remember regarding difference between not covered and covered under Gratuity Act. If he is covered under Gratuity Act, it takes 26 years. Not covered under Gratuity Act, only completed area of service is taken. Okay. She is not covered under the Gratuity Act 1972. Okay. How to calculate the salary? Exempted and taxable gratuity you see here. Okay. Mrs. Sneha for the year 2020-21. This is the table. Actual gratuity received is 3 lakh. Less exempted. First point, actual gratuity received 3 lakh. Maximum limit 20 lakh. Third point, half month salary for the completed area of service. This is to be calculated. I will calculate the salary first. Okay. You see here, salary is equal to salary plus DA eligible. DA eligible. Basic is 10,000. 10,000 is the basic plus 5,000 into 75%. I forget to put in bracket this amount. Salary is equal to 10,000 plus 3,750. 75% of 5,000 is 3,750. Therefore, salary is 13,750. 13,750 is the average salary. You remember this. Clear? And I will take that here. Half of this 13,750 into completed year of service is 25 is equal to 1,71,875. This is the third point. This is the third point. Least of the three is exempted. Least of these three is 1,71,875. You deduct 1,71,875 in the 3 lakh rupee. You deduct in the 3 lakh rupee. Remaining amount is 1,28,125 is the taxable gratuity. You calculate in this way. So taxable gratuity is balance. Balance is 1,28,125. This is the example based on employee not covered under the Gratuity Act 1972. Okay, this is the point you remember. You see the next example. One more example I will solve. Sri Akash retired on 31st March 2020. After serving 32 years, he completed 32 years of service. He received 78,000 as gratuity. Gratuity received is 78,000. His average monthly salary for the immediately 10 preceding months is 2,800. Okay, average salary is given. If average salary is given, you remember it is not covered under the Gratuity Act 1972. Remember this point. Okay, nothing is mentioned here. On the basis of that average salary, you have to consider that as a not covered under the Gratuity Act 1972. This is the point you remember. Okay. I will solve this problem. I am solving this problem because the specification is not given regarding the covered under Gratuity Act or not covered under the Gratuity Act. Okay, you see here. Akash, free Akash. First you take gratuity received 78,000. Exempted gratuity, first point, actual is 7,80,000. Second point, maximum 20 lakh. Third point, half month salary, calculated. Half of 1 by 2 into salary is 2,800. 2,800 into 32 years of service. 32 years is service year. So its answer is 44,800. 44,800. Therefore, least of these three is exempted. Least of the three is 44,800. 44,800 is exempted and remaining is taxable. Taxable amount of gratuity is 33,200. Okay, 33,200. Second example I solved. And one more example I'll solve on this. You see this. Mr. Ravi, who is not covered under the Gratuity Act, not covered under the payment of Gratuity Act 1972. It is clearly mentioned. He retired on 20th November. 20th November he retired. From and received 1,86,000 as gratuity. Received gratuity of 1,86,000. Okay. And completed year of service is 38 years, 10 months. 38 year, 10 months service is there, but it is considered as only 38 years because not covered under the Gratuity Act. Okay, 38 years is considered. His salary is ₹8,000 per month up to 31st July 2019. Up to July, his salary is 8,000. After July, his salary is 9,000 per month from 1-8-2019. Okay. So you have to calculate average salary here. Here you have to calculate average salary because salary is not same. Salary is not same for the previous 10 months. So you have to take 10 month salary and divide by 10. Divide by 10. And DA is 500 per month. There is no change in the DA. So DA 500 per month. And 69% is a part of computation for retirement benefit. 69% is the eligible for retirement benefit. Therefore, 69% DA you have to take. Okay. Here, only complication is regarding calculation of average salary. I'll calculate the average salary and show you. Okay. You see here. 10 months you have to consider. His retirement is in November. Before November means January to October. 10 months are there. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October. There are 10 months. Okay. In November, 11th month, he retired. So before retirement, you have to take 10 months. Okay. Out of 10 months, up to July end. July end means 7 months. 7 month his salary is 8,000 and August, September, October, 3 months. For 3 months his salary is 9,000. Okay, on the basis of these two conditions, you have to calculate average. You see here, computation of taxable and exempted gratuity. This is the table. Actual received is 1,86,000. Actual received is 1,86,000. Second point, maximum amount is 20 lakh. Third point, I will calculate. First salary. Okay. Half month average salary we have to calculate for completed year of service. So, there is a complication in the salary. You see here. 10 month salary is equal to first 7 month 8, thousand. So 8,000 into 7. January, February, March, April, May, June, July. 7 months, 8,000. Then from August, September, October, 3 months, 9,000. So I have taken 8,000 into 7 plus 9,000 into 3. It is the salary. Plus DA. DA 500, there is no change. 500 into 10. 500 into 10. Into 69%. 69% is eligible. Therefore, you have to take 69%. So, salary is 8,000 into 7, 56,000. 9,000 into 3, 27,000. Plus 500 into 10 into 69% is nothing but 1,340. Total, it is 86,450. 86,450 is the 10-month salary. 10-month salary is 86,450. Then you calculate average salary. Average salary is equal to total salary divided by 10 month is equal to 8,645 is the average salary. This salary I will take in this calculation. So 1 by 2 into 8,645 into 38 years. Amount is 1,64,255. Okay. Least of the three is 1,64,255. You deduct in the above call amount, balance is 21,745. 21,745 is the taxable gratuity. Okay. Three examples I solved on the not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act, and three problems I solved in the Gratuity Act, covered under the Gratuity Act. So you solve all the examples I have already uploaded in the video itself. You go through the video, solve the problems, making mute. You mute the video and solve the problem. Okay. These are the examples based on this. Example number 12, 14, 15. These are based on the not covered under the Gratuity Act. You solve on the basis of not covered under the Gratuity Act 1972. Okay. Next, 16, 17. You solve. These are the examples I have given. You solve these problems by tomorrow. And 18 number example is related with computation of pension. Taxable pension, exempted pension. Mr. Ram retired from the service. Mr. Ram retired from the service. His pension is ₹9,600 per month. Pension is 9,600 per month. And he got 2/3 of pension commuted for his financial problems, 2/3 total portion. Two-third of the total portion he taken, he received in lump sum ₹4,80,000. That is ₹4,80,000. Okay. So compute the exempted pension if he received gratuity, if he not received gratuity. You see here. If he received gratuity, 1/3 is exempt. If he will not receive gratuity, half is exempt. This is the point. But calculation is complicated. You see here. Computation of taxable and exempted gratuity of Mr. Ram for the assessment years 2020-21. Gratuity received. If gratuity received, what happens? You see here. This is the table. Actual gratuity pension received is 4,80,000. Less exempted. Exempted is he received the gratuity. Therefore, 1/3 is exempted. 1/3 of the commuted pension, not the 1/3 of the received. Remember this point. Not 1/3 of 4,80,000. Maximum students make the 1/3 of amount received. It is not 1/3 of amount received. It is 1/3 of commuted pension. You have to calculate commuted pension. You see here, I will calculate the commuted pension. Less exempted, that exempted is to be calculated on the basis of committed value. You see here, committed pension calculation. Pension received is equal to committed pension into portion received. What portion you received? This equation you have to apply. Pension received total is 4,80,000. You write at the 4,80,000. Below the pension received is 4,80,000 is equal to committed pension into 2/3. This 4,80,000, how they calculated? Out of total computed pension, 2/3 is received. 2/3 is received. Therefore, total committed pension into 2/3 is equal to 4,80,000. In this way, they calculated. So, you take 2/3 in the left hand side, okay, by interchanging the position. 4,80,000 into 3/2 reverse is equal to commuted pension. In this way, you have to calculate commuted pension. Commuted pension is equal to 7,20,000. In this way, you calculate commuted pension. Don't directly deduct 1/3 on the received. Pension received is 4,80,000 lump sum amount. This is the 2/3 of the commuted value. This is the 2/3 of the total commuted value. Therefore, and deduction is 1/3 or 1/2 is not on the basis of received. It is based on commuted value. Therefore, commuted value is to be calculated properly. So, less exempted. Exempted is 72,000 is the commuted pension into 1/3 is exempted. Into 1/3 is exempted. So, 2,40,000 is exempted. Remaining 2,40,000 is taxable. This, in this way, you have to calculate. Okay. Next, you see the not covered under Gratuity Act. Sorry, not received gratuity. Gratuity not received. What will happen? Gratuity not received. Okay, gratuity not received by Mr. Ram. Pension received is 4,80,000 into less exempt. Exemption limit is pension is 7,20,000 into 1/2. Half is exempted because gratuity not received. Half of the commuted value, not received value. Do you remember this? Here you make the mistake. So you remember this point. Half of the commuted value. Commuted value is 7,20,000. Okay. In case of pension calculation, you have to first calculate commuted value. So commuted value is 7,20,000. Half of that is 3,60,000. Therefore, remaining amount is 1,20,000. 1,20,000 is taxable. Okay. In this way, you have to calculate the pension. One more example I will solve. You see here. Example number 19. In the example number 19, Mr. Satish, a non-government employee, getting 20,000 pension per month. His monthly pension is 20,000. Okay. The employer calculated. Employer calculated total pension, commuted pension. Remember that as commuted pension. Okay. Total pension calculated and divided by the months, and it is monthly. If Mr. Satish is ready to take pension monthly, employer will give 20,000 per month. Okay, 20,000 per month. And during the year 1920, he committed the pension of rupees 12,000. 20,000 is monthly commission, and he commuted 12,000 pension. 12,000 pension means out of 20,000, whatever monthly he receives 20,000, out of 12,000 commuted means 12,000 portion is taken. And monthly balance remained is only 8,000. Remember this. 20,000 is the monthly pension. out of that 12,000 is commuted. Commuted means 12,000 portion is taken in a lump sum. Okay, 12,000 for the life period. 12,000 for the life period is taken. And its value is 4,50,000. Instead of taking monthly, total amount related with this 12,000 is taken in lump sum. That amount is 4,50,000. Then you ask to calculate the commuted pension. Okay. You see here, if he received gratuity, not received gratuity. Okay, this is the table, gratuity received. Gratuity received, what happens? Actual pension received is 4,50,000. Okay. Less exempted pension. Less exempted pension under section 10, subsection 10A. Now we have to calculate commuted value. Okay, commuted value is equal to, it is calculated on the basis of pension received. It is calculated on the basis of pension received. I'll write the equation. Commuted pension calculation. Pension received is equal to commuted pension into portion received. Okay, this is the equation. Pension received is 4,50,000. 4,50,000 is equal to commuted pension into 12,000. 12,000 portion is received out of 20,000 monthly. 20,000 monthly pension is there. Out of that 20,000 monthly, it received 12,000 portion. In balance, receivable monthly is 8,000. Okay. So 12,000 portion is commuted out of 20,000 monthly. Therefore, 12,000 divided by 20,000. You convert into, you take into left hand side, 4,50,000 into 20,000 divided by 12,000 is equal to commuted pension. Therefore, commuted pension is equal to 7,50,000. 7,50,000. Okay. 7,50,000 is the commuted pension. Then, as per your rule, if gratuity received, 1/3 is exempt. 1/3 of 7,50,000. 1/3 of 7,50,000 is 2,50,000. 2,50,000 is exempt. Remaining 2 lakh. 2 lakh is the taxable. Okay, this is the point. If gratuity received. Then what happens if gratuity is not received? Instead of 2/3, half is exempted. You see here. If gratuity is not received, you take actual pension received, 4,50,000. Less exempted, exempted pension is 7,20,000. Sorry. I'm unable to change it. It is fixed because of using the mathematical equation. It is fixed and I am unable to change it. It is 7,50,000. I copied from the previous example this amount. This amount is copied and now I am unable to change it. You take this as a 7,50,000. 7,50,000 into half is equal to 3,75,000. 3,75,000. So 3,75,000 is exempted and taxable is 4,50,000 minus 3,75,000 is equal to 75,000. 75,000 is taxable if it is not received gratuity. Okay. These are the examples I explained and tomorrow I'll explain how to calculate HRA. And you solve all the examples up to HRA. Okay. Whatever today I explained all the examples you solve tomorrow, by tomorrow evening. Okay.